First, the Dubliner Dorothy Smith, who has spent the last 30 years working as a visual artist. She's primarily interested in how the artist interacts with social and urban spaces. Most of her work is hand-drawn in pen or pencil, and recently she has turned her attention to this historic stadium at Dalymount.
I remember only too well.
I live here in Phibsborough and I'm really interested about my local environment, how it works, how it functions. Dalymount Stadium is a 5-minute walk from here and I can see it from my bedroom as it happens. And I have had a curiosity about the place for a long time, but I'm not interested in football. First one or two times I went in by myself, I kind of went, wow, what is this place? Because I knew nothing about it. It's really an extraordinary place and I couldn't believe that there's this huge, wide open, quite wild space in the middle of this really dense urban neighbourhood. Most of my work in the last 10 years has been drawing and drawings about the public space and the environment, the neighbourhood in which I live.
Dalymount, home to Bohemian Football Club for over 100 years, has seen many changes structurally. But in recent years, much of the stadium has been deemed unfit for purpose.
And I was kind of awestruck by the kind of materiality of it. There's so many different materials, textures, things built, half demolished, amended, adapted, structures from different eras. And you get all that sense when you walk in there. It's a totally different type of space and place than anything else that I've actually ever walked into.
In light of the fact that Dublin City Council bought the grounds in 2016 with plans to turn it into a municipal stadium, Dorothy and her friend urban geographer Jackie Burke set out to look in detail at this unique urban space.
And then myself and my friend and colleague Jackie Burke were talking about, you know, working together, and I kind of thought this might be a great opportunity to do something on Dalymount. So we came up with the bones of the project that became Dalymount, mapping a unique architectural space. And for a year and a half, we focused on Dalymount and worked on that. And that involved taking a lot of photographs, talking to an awful lot of people and exploring the place. And also, we were very keen to bring drawing into the whole project as well. Drawing is quite an anachronistic activity in this big technological age. It's very slow. It needs a pencil and a sheet of paper and absolutely nothing else. And I'm just really interested in what drawing can bring to the table in terms of exploring a local environment. So we organised a drawing day and over 50 people turned up. And as a result, we have all these amazing drawings of Dalymount as it is now, or as it was 2 years ago, from 5-year-olds up to, people in their 60s and 70s, from professional artists to adults who hadn't drawn since they were in school, and of course kids who are so relaxed and fluent when it comes to drawing. And so that was one of the results of that whole project, was this Dalymount the Colouring Book.
Dorothy and Jackie went on to make a video called Dalymount Bigger Than the Game. It captured the innate value that the club and grounds meant to people, not just within the football community, but also to local residents.
We got a really strong sense of how special this place is for people, you know, the kind of place attachment they have and the memories they have, and just how much it really means to them.
The research included speaking to lifelong fans of Bohemians, but they also spoke to those who remember the stadium for something other than football.
I'm not a football supporter, I've no interest in football, but Bohemian Football Club has always been part of my, I suppose, mental and physical landscape. One of the iconic gigs that happened here was Bob Marley, which happened in the 1980s, I think early 80s. You couldn't not go to it. I didn't have tickets, so we bunked over the wall and came, and it was just amazing. Like, having a superstar in Phibsborough was just amazing.
So this stand has a lot of significance for me, in particular 1C. It belonged to my granddad, Christy O'Brien. He's a member here for 50 years. I remember he'd take me up as a child and we'd sit here and we'd watch the game. His name engraved on this C.
In 2015, Bohemian Football Club invited local poet and third-generation Bows fan Lewis Kenny to become the first ever poet in residence for any football club in Europe.
Friday nights, follow the floodlights, fading memories of me granda, big Christy, gripping my hand with a tenderness loose, like the red and black scarf that hung frivolously, like a bold freedom around his neck. And as we advance through overshadowing trees along the North Circular, we can feel it. Delirium rising. My tribe calling me home once more, as it has done for the last 20 years. It's taken care of me, like you had always wanted it to. It's been a constant when you could no longer be. You always wanted a Pierce or a Plunkett. Bet you never thought I'd be that poet. And every now and then, the old guard will still stop me. Noel Farrell, still standing strong on his cornerstone of granite. Ah, you're Christie's grandson. A titan of a man your grandfather was. I wish I could know you now. To have one more game with you. But you have to do your own growing. No matter how tall your grandfather was.
Dorothy and Jackie's video highlighted the depth of feeling in the community for the old Dalymount Stadium in advance of the much-needed redevelopment.
It's a sort of a bittersweet moment when something will be lost, something will be gained, but through this project we've captured a lot of what means so much to people.
Both projects prompted Dorothy to use her love of drawing in order to help record some of the valuable history behind the stadium.
At the moment, what I'm doing is that I'm counting these crush barriers. So these were installed, as far as I know, in 1931, and they're a patented design by the architect Leach, who designed a lot of the terracing and stands here. And I'm just counting how many there are still left here, and there are 33 in total here on this terrace. So, but I think there were probably more because I know for a fact that there's one stuck up over there on a mud bank. But there's 31 at the moment. So I'm kind of interested in recording this kind of thing because this is all going to be lost. And like, for example, I've counted all the turnstile, the remnants of the turnstiles, and I think there's also 31 turnstiles. So all that kind of information I really want to include in the map. So I've always had an interest in maps. I think a lot of people do. They're very fascinating things. And I particularly like old hand-drawn maps. So these are all the drawings that are going to go around the actual map. And I've drawn them quite large. They'll be reduced in size on the actual finished map. This is a drawing of one of the floodlights, and these are really like almost the symbol of the stadium. Like, everybody knows these floodlights, and they can be seen from miles around. Then these two drawings show either end of the stadium. This end is called Tramway End because the trams used to go into these sheds here where the trams were stored. So this is called the shed end, but this stand here is called the Des Kelly Carpet Stand, which is a great name for a stand in a football stadium, I think, but Des Kelly was a huge supporter. But that shed, I only found out the other day, was actually built in 1910. This sign hangs over what's now the main entrance on Dalymount Lane. If you look at it closely, it's a beautiful handmade object. You can see where it's welded, where the metal has been cut, and where things like, you know, how it's held together by this main bar, and Limited had to kind of, you know, they had to space the letters out so that it would structurally stay sound. So it's a lovely crafted object.
Dorothy approached Dublin City Arts Office to help fund a publication to accompany her limited edition map of Dalymount Stadium.
Dorothy's approach is very, very interesting. Obviously, she's following in the footsteps of many great artists like James Moulton and Francis Place, whose work she actually cites as an inspiration in terms of artists who have documented their city. Yeah. So we associate a map with a topographical, factual description of a place, and we all, of course, use smartphones now to locate ourselves and look for coordinates. But the idea of actually producing a hand-drawn map of Dalymount Stadium is is really very interesting, because not only does it document the actual place, it documents the emotional attachment that people have to the place, and whether that is people who have come to Dalymount either as football fans, supporters, or coming to a concert. And all the imprints of, or the accretions of time, are evident if we look around Dalymount.
Dorothy's work has been welcomed by Bohemians Football Club, and board member Daniel Lambert has seen the value of recording the archive firsthand.
Really important that the history of Dalymount, you know, remains in various ways, and we'll always have photographs and things like match programmes, but to have an artist and for Dorothy to come in and look at that, I suppose, through new eyes, through the eyes of an artist, to do fantastic pencil drawings, that's something that, you know, in the absence of Dorothy's work wouldn't exist. And it gives a real snapshot of what Dalymount is like right now that isn't captured in a photograph or a film reel or captured in a match programme. And through different art forms, you can really engage with football, with sense of place, and with what sporting kind of clubs deliver and mean to people. Very often when people come to this stadium, we had Chelsea here last year, Frank Lampard's first game as Chelsea manager, and I spoke to the secretary of Chelsea Football Club, David Bernard, and they're used to hyper-modern facilities and what, you know, people would see as the best. And when he came here, and it happens very often with people like that, that come from much bigger clubs, in inverted commas, he loved the feel of the place. It almost feels like you've gone back in time in lots of ways. An artist can play a huge role in communicating that, preserving it, and giving people records to look back on.
I think this project is significant because it breaks down barriers in terms of the artist has been embraced by the club and all the people involved with the club and welcomed in, and information has been shared with her and access has been given. And I think that is very, very welcome, and it seems to be very much reflective of what Bohemians Football Club is all about.
The name Bohemians, the people who founded the club, had these really kind of, I'd say, good ideals in the ownership structure, and even in the name, it's more of a way of life. And this stuff naturally lends itself to, it needs to connect into the areas and the people around it to sustain its strength, because in the absence of private investment, you need people to invest time, energy and efforts. And the more artists, the more numerous groups that we link into, that's to the benefit of the club as a whole.
I think a lot of people might look at Dalymount and think, oh, it's really dilapidated. You know, the sooner it's knocked down, the better, kind of thing. But I'm kind of saying, no, look, this is a really valuable and interesting place. And these are the kind of places that we should value more than perhaps we do. So I suppose that's what the map is trying to do, is saying, look, this place matters. It's important.
The stadium at Dalymount has hosted names from Johnny Logan to Thin Lizzy, to soccer greats Pele and our own Johnny Giles. Bohemians are cognizant of the need to preserve that unique sense of history behind this urban space, and see Dorothy's work as vital to help achieve that.
It's a great sense of history in Dalymount, and you know, when the floodlights do come down, I think that will be a sad moment for a lot of people. And I think in 5 years' time, all of this is gone. The vast majority won't be here anymore, and to have a record of that from someone like Dorothy, and for people to have that on their wall, I think it's something that, you know, all Bohemians fans and a lot of people who live locally would have went to Irish international games and would have other links to the ground, would love to have and to treasure.
Fabulous work there by Dorothy, and lots of lovely memories from here at Dalymount. We're going to take a break now, but when we come back, we'll be bringing you more about those giants of soccer who played here on these hallowed grounds. We'll see you shortly.